In this chapter, we'll be discussing about economies of scale. This is the cost advantages that come with producing goods on large scale. Okay, so there are a lot of companies of different sizes. They might be producing the same good. Say, for example, say a cement company, cement manufacturing unit. There's a small unit that is manufacturing cement on a small scale. And then there's a major company manufacturing thousands of tons. So even though both of them are producing the same product, and assume for the moment that the quality is also same, but still the smaller unit will be incurring more cost. Okay, so there is, when you produce on a bulk scale, there will be an advantage, and that is that advantage we call as economies of scale. So this happens because as the number of units produced increases, the fixed cost per unit will decrease. Okay, so take for example, you wrote a book and you went to a printing press to get it printed. Okay, you wrote a novel and you went to a printing press to get it printed. You expect the first, you are expecting that 1,000 people will buy it. Okay, you're expecting there is a demand. However, you're doubtful, and instead of taking a risk, you think of first getting, what is the risk here? If you print 1,000 copies, maybe then your estimate might go wrong and only 500 people will buy it. Then the balance 500 will be lost to you. You already printed it, nobody's buying it. That is a risk. So instead, what you do, you say, okay, first let me print 100 copies, and once they are sold, I can order another 100 prints. Okay, that is another option. But if you know how printing press companies charge money, you'll realize that the company will say they will charge you 50,000 to print 100 copies and say 3 lakhs to print 1,000 copies. You just calculate the book printing cost, per book printing cost. In the first case, they're saying to print 100 copies will charge you 50,000, that is per book cost is 500. Whereas in the second case, they're saying to print 3 lakh copies, to print 1,000 copies, they'll charge 3 lakhs. That is per book cost is 300. So if you get more books printed, per book price is less. Okay, so if you know how printing presses work, this is because the printer has the same initial setup, irrespective of how many, they have these plates and all. Okay, so irrespective of how many books you print, the initial setup cost is same. So if more books are printed, that cost can be spread over many books, and therefore per book cost will reduce. That is economies of scale. Okay, so you derive cost advantage if you produce more number of items. This is the reason why large companies like, say, Reliance or ITC, they produce goods at comparatively lower cost than the competitors, because they produce at a much larger scale. And once you produce at a larger scale, your cost of production will reduce on a per unit basis. Okay, this is why smaller companies cannot compete effectively with larger companies. Those companies will be having a price advantage, the larger companies. Okay, that is economies of scale. So in interviews, they might ask you, what is meant by economies of scale? And why does the per unit fixed cost decrease as the number of units increase? Because when you produce on a large scale, the fixed cost can be spread over a large number of items. And they can ask you, give an example of economies of scale.